Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another live session of Getty Talks. My name is Shilpi, and I'm the Relationship Manager with the Global Education and Training Institute. Today, my guest is a very special guest. She was a computer engineer. She's a qualified computer engineer, but then she decided to give it up to fulfill her dream of becoming a teacher. She has an experience of 10 years in the field of education. She started off as a kindergarten teacher, and today she is a teacher of a higher secondary section. Her name is Ms. S. Jagatha Gokulam. She is the educator at Krishna International School, Ramanathapuram in Tamil Nadu. Welcome, Ms. Jagatha. And you know what? Her topic is also how to fulfill your dreams, which I am even eager to listen to. Thank you, ma'am, for being here, and over to you. And thank you for joining in the disruptive education movement started by Dr. Sunita Gandhi.
Good evening, ma'am. Very good evening, ma'am. I feel honored to be welcomed by you, Shilpi, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am, for giving me this wonderful opportunity. Once I think so, I have utilized this opportunity and made pride to myself and my parents. With my parents' blessing and love, I would like to start my today's session with the topic, how to make the dream come true. Why did I selected this topic? Is this was the same question I asked to the former 11th president, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. It was my one of my greatest dream to meet Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. It happened when I did my UG, and I was selected to ask question to him. The same question I asked to him, how to make the dreams come true. He replied with some of the answers that I'm going to discuss with you. Okay, hope so. You'll be setting your ears to me to listen and to make this session a successful one. Make use of this tips and make your dream come true. Okay, here, one of my lifetime achievement dream is to come on live. It might be a silly thing which you would laugh, but I want to be on live on Facebook. But my family situation, my family members will not to come, make me to come in live. So I was wondering and I was dreaming to come on live, which I got it from Getty GETI Institute on behalf of Shilpi ma'am. I thank her very much for giving me this opportunity once again. And I thank my school faculty members and the management people for encouraging me to do this live webinar session. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for Krishna International School for grooming me and for developing me and to making me to speak in this wonderful live session. Here we go into the topic, how to make dream come true. The first thing what Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, after hearing this question, he was laughing at me and asking how to make dreams come true. This silly question you are asking to me, your dream, you have to make it true. Why should you ask me this question? He asked me, but I once again repeated, sir, please, sir, for these many days, I was thinking so, dreams will only become true because of God's prayer and God's blessing from the God. But after hearing your speech, this question immediately arose on my mind. I was planned up to ask some other question, but after hearing your speech, this question strike out my mind. So only I'm asking this question to you. I replied to Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. Okay, fine. He told that he gave me some tips to achieve the dream. The first thing is be confident. Be confident. Wherever you go, you be confident that you are right. Only you can do it. Only you can do it. Be confident. Whatever you are doing, it might be a wrong or right. You can learn from the wrong thing. You can rectify your mistake. But be confident. Don't be afraid for anything. Be confident at all costs. At any cost, don't give up yourself. Be confident. That is the first tip which we want to follow for making our dream come true. First tip is be confident. Okay? Be confident. Okay? Second thing. Accept criticism, accept negativity. When we hear something that somebody is pointing wrong about us, what we will start to do, we will become sad, we will worry for it, but we should not do like that. we should accept the criticism. We should accept the criticism. Whenever you're doing something, ask to the people voluntarily, what any changes I have to do or any rectivity I have to make it. Ask, accept it. But you should not be negative. Be in a positive mood. If somebody is criticizing you, don't move away from the place. Accept it, hear it, set ears to it. Definitely you can achieve, because that criticism will make mania in your heart. It will give a vigorosity that it will make us to fight tougher and tougher, and it will not allow us to sleep until we achieve our dream. Okay, so accept negative criticism, but you have to be positive. Then third one is, don't cry for your failure. Be in a smiling manner. Sometimes you may cry, that is human, natural. Cry, but immediately leave that one and come back to your originality. Get up the spirit, get the spiritism of achieving the dream, then work for it. Fourth one is, you have to work harder but smarter. Smart work only makes the man successful. You have to work harder, but the work should be very smarter. If you work smarter, you can achieve your goal. Don't think so that your dream should be very bigger. Even it can be very smaller. You can consider me as an example. I am an engineering graduate. I can become a CEO of any company. I have that talent. I have that confidence. I have that capability. I have that capacity. But my dream is very smaller. I should not degrade myself. Being a teacher, I am so proudful that I am a teacher. I am educating many of the people, and I am a fuel to many person for achieving their dream. Okay, I am so happy for it. I am not feeling very bad about it. Okay, so don't degrade your dream. Based on your capacity level, you can decide your dream. And meanwhile, while achieving your dream, you can achieve many other dream also. The next one is, always consider your dream as your desire. Make your dream as your desire and goal. When you achieve your desire, you'll get the surpriseness. Same surprise you can get by achieving your dream. When you achieve your dream, you can get the same surpriseness. Surpriseness makes you happy and makes others also happy. And one secret which I want to share to you is, don't share your dream to anyone. Okay, until you achieve it, don't share your dream to anyone, because your dream should be a surprising factor for others. You should not share your dream to anyone. Be calm. Be bold. Be bold enough to face anything. Accept criticism, but you spread positivity. Be calm. Don't share your dream to anyone until you make that dream as a surprising factor to everybody. Everybody should feel that you are a wow factor. Wow, Jagada has achieved. When I shared this webinar link to everybody, everybody was shocked. Everybody was surprised that Jagada has got this opportunity. This was one of my lifetime dream which I have achieved. I have worked harder for it. I have worked smartly for it. I have confidence that I am capable person. I can do it. Okay, as such, you should also have the confident level, and you can definitely make it a successful one. Then always think, be selfish about your dream. Only you can do it. Only you can achieve it, because it's your dream. And only you can dream it. You can achieve it. You only know the value of the dream. You only know the worth of the dream. Okay, so only you should do it. Always, whenever some opportunity is coming for you, be selfless that you can do it. Be pride that only you can do it. Okay, definitely you can achieve your dream. And don't have the word try in your life. Okay, this would be a very new thing to you all. Don't have the word try in your life, because the word try has two options. One is success, another one is failure. When you try something, your brain will focus on the two options, success, failure. Either one we are going to achieve it. So it will not giving the work as a 100% one. When you try something, your brain will not give your hard work or potentiality to 100% level. It will be giving only for 50% level. So always do it. Always do it. Always make it happen. When somebody is giving you the opportunity, don't say, I will try, ma'am. I will try, sir. I can try it. Say, be bold enough to say, I can do it. I can do it. I only can do it. Definitely you can achieve your dream. Don't ask excuse for anything. Don't ask excuse for anything. If you ask excuse for anything, you are missing out your dream. You are losing the way to achieve your dream. Okay, when I got called from this Getty Institute to speak over in the live session, my inner soul was aching me to say, it was pricking me to say, Jagada, please say no. Because I was in a sad, depression mood. My inner soul was asking, you are very sad. How can you speak it out in the live session? You are going to get bad name from everybody. My inner soul was saying, immediately the step what I did is, I went and stand in front of the mirror and I asked to myself, facing to me, I asked to myself in standing in front of the mirror, whether I can do it or not. I myself gave a suggestion. Yes, Jagada, you can do it. You can do it. Definitely you're going to do it. You can rock on the stage. As such, I gave advice to myself. So what I'm coming to say from this is, be you yourself, be your best friend. You yourself, share your secrets among yourself. Whenever you are coming, you are facing up any situation, bad situation, try to speak yourself in front of mirror or writing a letter. Give a promise to yourself that you can succeed in your life. You can success your dream. So always give promise to yourself to make your dream come success. Don't ask excuse for anything. Okay, that is what I'm coming to say. Next one is, try to face the hurdles that you are facing in your way to achieve your dream. Try to face the hurdles. Okay, if you are facing more hurdles, don't get disappointed and sit in a place, take rest for idle, and then you can move over. Don't have that concept. Okay, try to face the hurdles. If you face the hurdles, you will have lot of ideas. You will have lot of ideas how you can overcome your dream. That is learning through experience, everybody will say, no. As such, it is hurdles. If you try to face your hurdles, if you try to face the problem, you will get many solutions. You will get many pathways to achieve your dream. Enjoy your experience. Enjoy your experience of achieving your dream. Enjoy your experience. Think about the past, how you have achieved your dream. Think about the past. Definitely it will be a great enjoyment. If I am thinking about my dream was to become a teacher, yeah, I have achieved it. And my another dream was to become the faculty member of Krishna International School. Yeah, that too I have achieved. If I thought about that, I'm getting into the happy mood. Still many dreams I have. Still I am fighting for it. Still I am working for it. Definitely I will achieve it. Then the next thing which I want to give you a small tip was read many books. That everybody will say. Even Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam also insisted me, if you don't find to time read books, now everybody are using smartphone, Android phone. You can hear the book. You can hear the sound app book. Many apps are there. Many e-books are there. Read many books. through books you can get many ideas. Through books you can get many ideas. Definitely by reading the books, being as a teacher, I am sharing many thoughts to my kids, which is also one of my dream that I am fulfilling it. So read many books. Don't ask excuses. Don't get disappointed for anything. Accept the hurdles. Be positive. Accept the criticism. Then be confident to face all the dream. Don't be overconfident. Be confident. All the successful persons, they have written in their article that they are confident. They are very confident. Always think about your dream. Each and every step in your life should be always thinking about your dream. If you are thinking about your dream, that is your desire, definitely you will work for it. Your inner conscious mind itself will prove you that you have to achieve for your dream. You have to work for your dream. Definitely it will be saying, it will be proking you. Even if you feel lazy and if you sit idle, if you get frustrated, appa, we don't want to work for our dream, let it go away. If you thought also, your inner soul will be pricking you that you have to go along in the path that what you are going to achieve and what you are going to succeed. It will itself be saying. So always have touch with your inner heart. The next tip which I am going to say you is the always be in a smiling face. Always be in a smiling face. Your smiling face will definitely give confidence for you. Your smiling face will make others to feel happy, that they will spread positivity around you. The positive vibes will make you to achieve the dream. So always be in a smiling face. Always be in a smiling face. Definitely your smile will remove all the depression and sadness from you and the negativity around you. Everything will be removed because of your smile. If you feel like crying, go and stand in front of the mirror. See your face for a while. Definitely your tears will get away. It will run away from you. Then you can achieve your dream definitely in a very faster manner. And don't bother that your age is running away. Okay, dream can be succeeded in a smaller age or at the elder age. So don't bother about the age. Keep on thinking about your dream. Okay, don't bother about your age. If you have the guts and confidence level, your health also will be in a better manner. Your health also will be in a better manner, and definitely it will boost up your confidence level. And it will make you to achieve the dream. Then, if you want to take relax from your dream, set a short-term goal. If you want to make a relaxation in achieving your dream, set a short-term goal. For example, my dream, I have one dream right now in my mind. It is a long-term goal. It is a long-term process which I'm going to do for it. Until I achieve the dream, I would have a small dreams like buying a car, buying a home, or buying a jewel. This would be also my dream because it is one of my desire which I am going to achieve through only through my work, only through my hard work, and only through my smart work. As such, achieve short-term goals, then proceed with your long-term goals. Okay, so this life is a thing which is also a dream that is gifted by the God through our parents. Okay, so we have to enjoy our life by dreaming more and more. Don't set only one dream in your life. Have many dreams as like many branches in the tree. You are the trunk of the tree, and you should have many branches, many dreams in your life which you can achieve through the way which I have told. Once again, I would like to repeat the ways through which you can achieve the dream. The first thing is be confident. Be confident in achieving your dream. Always be confident. Be bold enough to face any problem. Then second thing is don't let use the word try. Always use do. Always use the word do. Don't cry for anything. Be in a smiling face. Be calm. be calm at all the situation. Don't share your secret, don't share your dream with anyone. Have it as a secret until you achieve it. Everybody should be getting surprised as such you have achieved your dream. Then accept the hurdles that you are facing in the dream. Then next one is set short-term goals until you achieve your longest dream. Have many dreams in your life as like a branches in the tree. And one small tip which I gave is read many books so that you can get many ideas, many thoughts, and many positive vibration will spread in your mind definitely by reading many books. And the thing which is very, very foremost important thing is respect your parents and give importance to your parents' words. Respect your parents and give importance to your parents' words. Even though it may be sometime our parents may go wrong or they may be right, give importance, accept the message which they are giving, analyze it once or thrice. Then if your inner soul told that you can accept it, you can definitely go in the path. Don't focus, don't have only one path for achieving your dream. Have many paths. Okay, as like the William Wordsworth has written in his poem, Road Not Taken, you can have many paths in your life to achieve your dream, but choose the best way and the right way to achieve your dream. Then give time for your family members also. That is very, very important. By achieving the dream, don't get frustrated, don't get depressed that I couldn't achieve the dream, our dream has become a failure. Don't think so as such. Okay, participate with your, or involve with your family members, involve with your friends. Give time, spare some time with your family members so that they may give some supportive messages, they may give some supportive tips to achieve your dream. Then the next thing which I'm going to say is always have your inner soul as your best friend. Ask to it what all the things you are doing. Please ask to it. Only you can judge yourself. Others can criticize you, the other can apprise you, but the judging person should be only you. If you judge yourself and if you start to analyze yourself, you can find whether you are going in a right way or a wrong way. If you find the right way or wrong way, you will correct yourself and you will rectify the mistake, and that will make you to achieve your dream sooner. So be judge for yourself. Always try to use the word I can, I should, and I will do it. Okay, always try to use the word I can, I should, and I will do it. Definitely all your dreams will come true with all positive vibes and all the prayers, and hope so. You'll also be suffering all your blessings and love on me and encouraging me to achieve all my dreams. Hope so this tips what I told would be a useful one for you, and I have made this live session an effective one, I think so. And I would like to thank Silpi ma'am for giving me this opportunity. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, Mrs. And you know what? I mean, not a single word did I miss. And I believe my audience also did not miss a single word that you said. And as you were quoting Dr. Kalam, so it actually brought more attention to it. Well, this is for our, audience who are watching. And I think there are some questions that are in their mind, and I would like to ask it on their behalf. Before our live session began, we were discussing something about imagination and dream. You know, so our youngsters, I would like you to answer this for our youngsters who are more into imagination rather than dreams. You know, they cannot differentiate between the two. And that is what happens when they face a failure or when they are not able to achieve it. Then they conclude a point that life is very practical, you know. You should not live in dreams and you should not be dreaming. because they forget that there is a subtle difference between imagining things and between dreaming things. So yes. Would you be able to give that little...
Ma'am? Ma'am? I hope so, Silpi ma'am asked me to differentiate what's the difference between dream and imagination. I already mentioned that a dream should be your desire or your goal. Imagination is the virtual, that is virtual, making you virtual, as like playing in PUBG, Free Fire. That will not happen in our life. Imagination will be and just an virtual room which we cannot enter into. Just we can feel the feel of happiness. But dream, it will give us surprises. It will happen in our real life. It is a miracle which we are achieving through the hard work and the smart work. So imagination, the difference between the imagination, you have to think over. Imagination, you can feel it. You cannot you see the excitement by imagining. But by achieving the dream, you can surprise, you can get the surprise and you can feel the happiness in your inner soul that you will be satisfied with what is happening in and around. So imagination, don't get into the imagination. Make your dream come true. Think about your dream in future reality, how it will be. For example, if your dream is to become an IAS, you are dreaming from the age of 5, you always dream, always imagine that you are a collector, you are in the collector's room, you are ordering, you are proposing some order, you are some proposing some proposals, making some rules and regulations. That thing would be an imagination, but imagining about illusion things is not a correct way. I hope so, my answer would be a justifying one. Silpi ma'am. Don't sacrifice your dream for anybody. Okay, even they may be your parents or maybe your family members, any of your family members. If you are focused on your dream, don't sacrifice it for anybody at any cost, because it's your dream. Only you can make it happen. Nobody cannot come and replace yourself. So don't sacrifice your dream for anybody. Dream is equivalent to desire and desire is equivalent to the goal. So don't sacrifice your dream for anyone.
All right. There was some disruption actually. I'm really sorry for the network issue. There's something happened with the network. So yes, I believe that he has been able to give you an entire explanation between the difference between your dream and your imagination. And yes, what happens, this would be my last question to you. Okay, there's somebody asking you a question. This is Dulasi Stalin. How to get rid of inferior feelings, you know? Yes. This is something that even I was coming to. You know, these days, you know, social media is so much active. And, you know, every now and then people are posting their achievements, you know? on the social media. And if you go to YouTube, everybody is on the channel. Everybody is speaking something or the other. And a nobody, you know, a nobody has become somebody on that channel. You know, people who we actually never knew about, but because of, you know, they have started coming online and they have started doing so much of things that they are making a place. So what happens is that children who are watching or youngsters who are watching, they also get that feeling. I want to be like them. So, you know, is that real achievement? How would you define a real achievement to a child? Is it just becoming famous? You know, just getting yourself being noticed in the society, is that actually success? Or success is something that, you know, you need not be recognized by people all around. These days, people define success as being recognized in society. If 10 or more people know me, my things are being liked on social media, people are following me, I'm a successful person. All right. But then there might be another person who's actually very successful, but is not being noticed. So with that person, so they feel depressed. Or, you know, if you tell them, oh, you are doing good, they say, oh, no, nobody notices me. You know, I mean, look at him. People talk about him. So would you like to make this difference clear to the people who are watching and to the youngsters especially, that what is success in real words, and very practical words?
Yeah, success, it means that when you achieve it through your hard work and smart work with your own capacity and capability, that means you are success. Okay, success is not getting fame through the likes and unlikes which you are getting in WhatsApp, Instagram and other social medias. It is when you achieve it through your own hard work and capability, that is your own success. For example, if you are seeing pulped mango in a mango tree, and if you are trying to pluck it from the mango tree, but you couldn't do it, you are very small, but you are somewhere trying to climb the tree, and if you are plucking, at that time you will feel some happiness in your eyes and your smile will fragrance in your face. At that time you will say to yourself, we have plucked our own mango fruit, I have plucked the mango fruit by myself. That is the success. If you get the success through your hard work and through your capacity, that is the success. Don't get it by the promotions and by the other people appraisal. Don't accept the appraisal, first of all. When somebody is appraising you, yeah, you have done, it's awesome, you are very good, you are highly intellectual person. As such, if somebody is saying, don't set your ears to them. Be calm. What your inner soul should say, that you have achieved it, and your inner thought should make you bold up that you have achieved it. At that time only it is a success.
Right. I think you have actually solved Aquarius, and I believe those youngsters who are watching us, they have understood what it is not to be crazy about all the promotions that you get on the social media, because it's just, you know, it's not a platform, it's not a benchmark of your success. All right. It's not a benchmark of your success. Maybe those people who are getting those promotions and who are being recognized, in their reality, in the real life, they might not be that successful the way you are. So I think this has to be made very clear to our adolescents and to our youngsters, especially, that getting attention on social media, giving your efforts on the social media to become more popular and to get, and that is a benchmark of success. Actually, it is not, because that is not sustainable for a very long time. It is a very futile platform, and it's a very futile success that you're getting. So it's a very good evening that I had spent with you, Ms. Jagannath, because actually, such discussions rarely happen these days. And sharing your views in a very nutshell also, you know, we read so many self-help books, how to become successful, 10 keys to become successful. But then here, I think, what do you call the entire squeezing out the juice of the entire fruit of success. That's what you have done here. Thank you so much. And it's been lovely having you here and listening to you. I did not even miss a single point. And I believe not even my audience. So thank you so much. And happy Dashara to all of you. And stay tuned in for another talk like that. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thanks Bye. Everybody for watching me. Thank you so much and keep supporting me. Thank you all. Thank you, Silpi ma'am, for giving me this wonderful opportunity.
My never pleasure.
You in my life. This is the first opportunity.
We will never forget you. Getty is not going to forget you, because this is one of our most, out of those 400 people that have, you know, graced our platform. You are one of those people, a few number of people, gems who have been here. And it's really been really nice. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much. Keep in touch with me as a friend. Thank you so much.
Good night. Good night.